You're coming at a period where you had virtually every significant wrestling writer in America on your show within a month span. And in this case, in this show, you've got two. And the first one, as we spoke about earlier, is Alex Marvez.
Yeah, Alex is somebody that I got to know fairly well. I got to meet him in New York when he had come up for some of the shows. And he was a hard-hitting journalist back then, not only with his column with the Miami Herald, but he was one of the top guys back then. A lot of people respected him for everything he did. And, of course, Alex has gone on to have just a pretty amazing career as a sports reporter, writer, and now he's with AEW.
Yes, he also is an NFL guy for SiriusXM Radio.
Yes, still to this day, I think.
Yeah, right? Absolutely. So it's quite a career. So why don't we listen to Alex, because he's going to pick up the ball on the steroid information that was going on at that point. And you were, you know, such a big hand in, John.
Well, yeah, let's let Alex join us from 30 years ago.
You know, Alex, I don't know how many years you followed the business, but of course it's changed so much since I first started watching it. There would never have been a show like this one or columns that appear in the Miami Herald if the wrestling business did not change and pretty much expose itself over the last 10 years.
Yeah, it's interesting how wrestling's evolved and how the promoters have stayed in the dark ages instead of going along with wrestling columnists, wrestling radio shows, and just agreeing to things. Like if there's a wrestler who's being advertised for a show and he's not going to appear, change your advertising. Instead, promotions seem to think that, well, they're going to do their business their own way and no one's going to force them to change anything.
Yeah.
So a lot of promoters, they want it one way. They want to, you know, have their cake and eat it too. And, you know, it's really interesting. And that's the good thing about your radio show and about my column in the Herald, not so much me, but my column, is that I can get out information to people about things that have been changed, about lies that are being put forth by promotions, about the steroid problem in wrestling. And I mean, this is a great venue for it. And yes, this wasn't even conceivable 10 years ago, let alone, you know, 7-8 years ago.
Right. It certainly has changed. The biggest wrestling story of this year, I would have to say, has been the steroid issue. And a lot of people, I've heard comments, well, you harp on the steroid issue too much, you know. Why don't you take the show with a lighthearted approach? And, you know, you reported on that once before. Why keep harping on it? Well, keep harping on it because nothing's been done in the wrestling business about changing I don't even think there's been a drug testing yet for steroids in wrestling.
No, there hasn't been a World Wrestling Federation steroid test. There hasn't been a World Championship Wrestling steroid test. It's and even the World Wrestling Federation's drug testing policy is an in-house policy. I mean, you know, none of the results are ever made public, and who knows who fails, who knows who doesn't. There have been suspensions issued, but I talked to a World Championship Wrestling employee after my story came out, and he compared it to the tree falling in the woods.
Yeah.
You know, what difference does it make if no one hears it?
Yep.
But what promoters don't understand is that there's going to be an incredible backlash against steroid use and abuse within the next few years if they don't clean up their own act. And they can continue to try to ignore it, they can continue to try to be ignorant, but it's not going to go away.
I haven't had the luxury of reading the entire piece that was published in the Miami Herald this week. And for our listeners out there, I know it was picked up on the AP wire services, I believe. I don't know if it got any coverage here in the New York area. I think the timing for your particular story might have been a little bad here due to the fact that Robert Maxwell, the publisher of the Daily News, died unexpectedly this week, and the paper focused an awful amount of space to covering his death. And then, of course, the tragic situation of Magic Johnson also dominated not only the sports pages but the major headlines this week. So a story focusing around the story that you published in the Miami Herald that was picked up on the AP services may have not been printed in a number of the newspapers in the metropolitan area, especially here in New York.
Yeah, but I believe Phil Mushnick's going to be doing a piece, and Phil seems to be the only only person in the New York media besides yourself and a couple others that don't want to let this story get away.
Mm-hmm.
And that have not just ignored. Like, you remember in July there was a big boom of papers. Yeah, let's do a steroid story. Let's do a steroid story.
Yeah.
And everyone went out. They wrote these steroid stories. Vince McMahon got pressured into announcing a steroid test. Well, it's November. There's no steroid test. And where's the New York media? They're not doing anything. About the only guy that would do something is Mushnick. and that's it. And it's not a personal vendetta against Vince McMahon like some people in the World Wrestling Federation seem to think. I mean, he realizes that this is a problem, that this is entertainment being portrayed to children around guys who take steroids, who take an illegal drug, and that's wrong.
Mm-hmm. Well, you're Muchnick, of course, here. If he comes out with a piece, obviously it's going to get a lot of attention. The last time Phil ran a piece, it was regarding the Vince McMahon press conference here. And that certainly opened up the invitation to visit the Titan Sports offices, which took place a little after that. So Phil has read it. Obviously, it's in a major newspaper, so it will get a lot of attention.
Oh, this isn't a story, John. I think you know that is going to go away. I mean, over the next 5 years, I'm going to keep writing about this, and I know other writers are also, that there is a steroid problem, and as more wrestlers suffer health problems, as more wrestlers get arrested with steroids, such was the case with Tom Zenk, as more wrestlers, you know, run into problems with this type of thing, and promotions run into problems, and advertisers start turning off, and kids' parents start realizing, hey, these guys are doing illegal things, well, don't watch this stuff. Only when the TVs turn off, and only when there's some sort of regulation or government involvement is this situation going to be cleared up.
Mm-hmm. For those out there who didn't get a chance to see the Wire Service article or the Miami Herald, can you give us a synopsis on what actually was published in the Miami Herald written by you this past week?
I sure can. I wrote a story in the state of Florida looking into regulating professional wrestling in Florida. New York, as you know, has regulation, as do 23 other states and the District of Columbia. This was really brought on by the steroid revelations from the George Zahorian trial. Zahorian was the Pennsylvania osteopath who was convicted on 8 counts of distributing steroids to wrestlers in the late 1980s. Now, I received a Federal Express transcript of the wrestlers on that list, and there were 39 wrestlers on that list. And you talk about names that received packages from Zahorian, and we're not sure what was in these packages exactly. Before I read this list. But, I mean, you've got Jake Roberts, Bam Bam Bigelow, Hulk Hogan, Ken Patera, Don Morocco, Roddy Piper, Greg Valentine, Eddie Gilbert, Mr. Perfect Kurt Hennig, The Ultimate Warrior, Hercules, Junkyard Dog, Virgil, Paul Orndorff, Bob Orton Jr., Randy Savage, Rick Rude, and the Big Boss Man. You've also got an amount of drugs. The reason that you could suspect they're steroids, now I'm not saying that they did take them, but there was a chart presented by the government in the Zahorian trial, a comparison of the drugs purchased by Zahorian and the amount provided to patients for the period of September 1988 to March 1990. Out of steroids, he had a drug called Anavar, which is a steroid. He purchased 8,500 tablets and distributed 330 to patients. Methyl testosterone, another common steroid, he purchased 28,000 tablets, provided only 230 to patients. And the rest of the chart is similar. The same thing with acetaminophens and sedatives, like Valium. He asked for 7,000 tablets of Valium, he prescribed 20 to patients.
That's incredible.
Oh, the drug discrepancy is incredible with Zahorian. And the World Wrestling Federation's top stars receive these packages. I pointed that out. I explained how Hogan received packages. He wouldn't return phone calls.
Okay, but as far as... these packages were sent Federal Express by Zahorian to these individuals. Once again, there's no proof, per se, what was in the contents of these Federal Express packages.
You're absolutely right. There was no proof. The only thing that we know is that four of the wrestlers who received Federal Express packages, Brian Blair, Danny Spivey, Roddy Piper, and Rick Martel, all testified that they received steroids from Zahorian. Also, Zahorian said that he sent steroids to Hulk Hogan, Vince McMahon, and Lord Alfred Hayes. When I asked Zahorian about whether he prescribed steroids to whether he sent steroids to Hogan, he said, "What do you think?"
Mm-hmm.
So it was already elaborated on in testimony. He pointed out that some of the packages that he sent to the World Wrestling Federation, he sent 13 packages totaling 36 pounds. He said he never sent a steroid to the World Wrestling Federation. He said that he sent back merchandise and other medicine.
Okay.
I don't know what type of medicine exactly. I haven't been able to speak to him further. But he seemed willing to talk, and over the next week I'm going to have a chance to talk to him. It's just been real busy because I cover the University of Florida football team also, and I've been traveling across the country following the Gators, and it's been crazy.
Yeah, it sounds as though you've been keeping a very hectic schedule. Now, with Zahorian, his sentencing is scheduled to be coming up soon, isn't it?
Yeah, and he's going to appeal too, and I think he's got a decent shot of having a retrial. And if he does, you're not going to see Hulk Hogan escape a subpoena like he did in the Zahorian trial. I think you're really going to see the World Wrestling Federation's top stars and maybe even owner Vince McMahon having to testify that they purchased steroids if they did that.
Mm-hmm.
And it's going to just revive the whole steroid thing because the media has gotten lax. The New York media has gotten lax. It's a shame, too, because I can write a story in Miami, but if New York doesn't see it in a lot of ways, the World Wrestling Federation won't panic.
Yeah.
And that's unfortunate, but that's just the reality of the situation, even though the Herald's one of the top 10 papers in the country.
Well, it's been a story that you've been following closely, and a number of us have been in the business, but the story in the Herald was termed, put to me, it was pretty explosive, and I could see why with all the names that you have listed that at least received packages, although we don't know what were in those packages. You know, there's a number of names on that list.